Second Chronicles.
And the Lord appeared to Samuel by night and said unto him, I have heard thy prayer and have chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. If I shut up heaven and let me no rain, or if I come in and look into the vow of the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. The next one is Proverbs chapter 14, verse 34. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 34. Righteousness is exalted a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Matthew chapter 7, verse 21 through 23. Bishop, I went to preach at a Baptist church some time ago, and I had finished preaching. I'm getting ready to sit down. The Lord said, read Matthew 7, chapter 21 through 23. Right. And Sister Jake, when I read that, the pastor almost fell out of his chair. So I want you to listen to what Jesus is saying.
Okay.
Come on.
Not everyone. That said unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven.
Yes, sir.
Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord,
yes, they will.
Have we not prophesied in thy name?
Yeah.
And in thy name have cast out devils. And in thy name done many wonderful works. And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you.
Look at that.
Depart from me, ye that work iniquity.
Yes, you do.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'd like you to read that behind it. Isaiah 35 and 8.
All right. Hallelujah. This is an old scripture that we came up in the church with, and it's not going to change.
Amen.
Isaiah 35 and 8. And a highway shall be there, and a way. And it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it. But it shall be for those wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein.
Amen.
The
Amen.
Last scripture I have for you today is Revelation chapter 20. Revelation chapter 20 and verse 10. Hallelujah. People think that they can live any kind of way to get to heaven, but they're fooling themselves.
Preach.
Hallelujah. Heaven is a holy place. To get there, you've got to be holy. Not just in one way, but every way. Thank you, Lord.
You already
preached. Revelation chapter 20 and verse 10.
All right.
Thank you, Lord.
And
the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. All right, for there in the verse 14 and 15, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And whosoever was not found in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire.
Yes, they were.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
My thought to you today is this. Sin is not worth going to hell
for. It's not. Can you preach it now? Hey,
come on.
Sin is not worth going to hell for.
Come on.
First of all, you want to know what is sin. Sin is everything that's unrighteous.
Yes.
Thank you.
Sin is what got the world in the shape that's in today.
Yeah.
Amen.
When the devil deceived Eve and Adam in the garden, he told them, if you will disobey God and do this, then you will be like God.
Amen.
But let me tell you something, the devil has lied to you.
Yes, he will.
Amen. Satan is the master of lies.
Yes, he is.
Everything he tells you is a lie.
Everything. Amen.
You know, I want to tell you, Brother Hunter and I, we was at a prayer breakfast about 3 weeks ago. And then after the message, the pastor said, who's on prayer? That was a preacher came up, and I had never seen him before. And his prayer request was this. His wife, son, and daughter was in Chicago. And the daughter and the son got in a fight over a cell phone. And she took a big old kitchen knife and stabbed him in his stomach.
Jesus!
And they had ruptured his lungs.
Come on.
When they took him to the hospital, the doctor said he's not going to live but 2 or 3 days because his lungs are messed up. He said that he's not going to live but 2 or 3 days because his lungs are messed up and he couldn't breathe. So when the service was over and I was getting ready to walk out the door, he came to me and said, do you have a message for me? I said, let me tell you something. While I'm talking to you, Jesus is working on your son.
Amen.
I said, your son's going to be all right.
Hallelujah.
So he got to Spain and went to Chicago. When he got to the hospital, the family was in there crying, and the doctor told him, y'all may as well stop crying. He's all right now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus is everywhere.
Everywhere.
He's a right man, God.
Yes,
yeah,
he is.
Pastor, Bishop Bellamy was right. A lot of this junk y'all see on television talking about church, that ain't nothing but the devil's work.
That's all.
Nothing but that's the all. Devil's work. Yeah. One of them was telling the people that did about Moses saw God face to face. No, he didn't. God told Moses that God was going to pass the backside by Moses so no man could see God face to face. You got to know the word of God for yourself.
Yes, you do.
Because if you don't, the devil's going to deceive you. In this day and time, it's so sad. People running to church all the time, wearing all kind of big titles.
Yeah,
all
yeah.
kind of fancy clothes.
Yes, they do.
They think the title gonna make them.
No,
yeah. But I got news for you.
Yes, yeah.
The salvation is only through Jesus.
Yes, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Hey.
The seminary not gonna teach you how to get saved.
Amen.
A lot of them are not saved.
A lot of them saved.
They can't. Jesus said many are called, but few are chosen.
Yeah, that's right.
To be a real disciple of God, you have to be chosen.
Yeah.
To be chosen by God, you got to go through the stone.
Preach.
Hallelujah.
Preach.
Thank you, Lord.
Preach it.
Every day is not going to be Sunday.
Yes.
Right.
I've had people come to me in the last few days and say, we've been praying for a long time and God haven't done nothing yet. I say, why are you talking? He's still working.
Yeah. He's still working.
When the devil told her she must be doing something wrong, I said, the devil's a liar. Yeah. Job didn't do nothing wrong.
Amen.
Joseph didn't do nothing wrong.
Amen.
That's the stone they had to go through.
That's right.
We got a stone to go through. We're going to have fire and trials. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we got to hold on to God.
Oh,
you know, I ain't talking about, you know, hell. I don't mind going to hell. A young lady told me, 14 years old, she didn't mind going to hell because she was going to burn up. I said, you are so wrong.
Amen.
Your soul going back, you're going to God, but your body going to the dust. Your soul is not going to die.
Yeah.
Your soul is going to be alive so you can suffer the punishment for disobeying God.
Yeah. Now see, you preach.
I used to think that hell was the worst could happen, but it's not. There's a place worse than hell.
Jesus.
And it's called the lake of fire and brimstone.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
Anybody know what brimstone is? When you put fire with brimstone, it gets so hot it'll burn his way through iron. And you're not going there for a little bit. You're going to be there for day and night, forever and ever.
Amen.
You're going to be tormented in the flame. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They talk about how did you see on earth. I said, you better get used to it. Boy, you're going to be a lot hotter than that.
Amen.
You can sing in the choir church.
Jesus.
You can pastor church.
Yeah.
You can be the senior bishop of the church.
Come on.
But if you don't live holy, you're going to hell.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. They don't want to hear you mention hell. They think everybody's going to heaven.
Huh.
Somebody sang in the choir and they died, they in heaven. That's a lie.
It is.
They up there looking down as if anything, they're down there looking up.
Amen.
We don't be judged according to our works.
My God.
Well, and if our works don't bow us out, we're going to end up in the lake. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
I say many times, and I'm saying to you today, there's not a one of us here today.
Right.
That can turn your oven on and let it get real hot and stick your feet in there and let it stay there for a while.
Amen.
Or turn your oven on and the stove on and grab one of them grills and hold it in your hand. You can't do it. Because the heat from that will make you draw back. But in hell is a one-way journey. Hallelujah. You can't get out of hell.
Come on.
God said in the day of judgment,
preach
he will temper justice without mercy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Today we have mercy.
Yes.
But in the day of judgment won't be no mercy.
No.
Yeah, mercy.
Not going to do you no good to cry and bellyache and all that because you're going to the lake.
Yeah.
We're going to be judged according to our words.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You've got women who won't be church mothers that run around lying to their grandchildren speaking evil things about God's people.
Yeah.
But remember this. God said Elijah was a man like we are.
Yeah.
Elijah had prayed, and when he said something, God honored it.
Yeah.
And I say many times, these liars that are lying on God's people, God gonna start putting bars on their tongue.
My God.
Let it stop you from running your mouth.
Yes,
let it stop you tell you, hallelujah.
Yes, they will.
Tell them to go pray for them, hallelujah.
Yeah.
When you talk about somebody, you're not helping them and you're not helping yourself.
You're not helping nobody.
Jesus said, what you do to the least, the least you're doing unto me. Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
And I want you to know one thing, lady, this is a missionary. And she was about to throw in the towel because people were talking about her. I said, you haven't read the scripture. Jesus said, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
Yes, they are.
But they know not the scripture, nor the power of God.
They don't know nothing about God.
It's a sad shame. People calling themselves pastors don't even know the word of God.
Don't even know it.
How you going to teach them the truth when you don't know the truth?
Don't know it.
Hallelujah.
Come on, preacher.
They're earning everything except God.
Yeah.
The politicians are bringing America back. Where has America gone? They took God out of the school.
Yeah.
They took God out of the school.
Come on.
They trying to take the name of God off of the money.
Yeah.
And they wonder how so much it happened.
Come on.
Yes, yes.
I don't care how much money you spend, you can't stop the disease from coming.
Yeah.
You can't stop ISIS and nobody from blowing up building. He's going to take the power of God.
Yeah.
And we got to seek the Lord. Sometimes they didn't have to lift a finger. They prayed and God delivered. Hallelujah.
Right.
He's the same God today. He got that same power.
Yeah.
Man can say what he wants, but God got the last say. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And if you would give God some time and stop sitting in front of the TV set all the time, then you can get somewhere with God.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
I went to one church to preach, and the pastor wife got him saying, my husband don't have no money because he's sitting in front of the TV set all the week with a ring over his hand. I say, God is not going to hunt you to watch television.
Amen.
You need God to learn to know the word of God.
Yes, sir.
Right. Ain't to, don't let him in your church. He's going to tear up your church. First of all, it's not your church.
Hey. It's not your church.
It belongs to God. If you stand in the middle of one show, God will take care of you for that.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. When God speaks to you and tell you something, you ought to have enough brain to know how to obey God. He listened to his wife.
Come on, God.
He told me, he said, you've been a pastor before. I'm new at this. Can you help me? I said, everything the Lord gives me, I give it to you.
See, now you're preaching now.
I even told him, he came back. My wife told me, I don't have to listen to you. I said, look at that. God said, I'll take care of you.
Amen.
One Sunday morning at 3 o'clock, the Lord called his name out loud. He looked over at his wife, thought it was up, but she was asleep.
Come on.
God told him, said, if you don't do what I take, them will kill you, bring your dead.
Come on.
And he wouldn't obey God. Took him to the doctor. Doctor said, take him home. We can't do nothing for him. He stayed on his bed 9 months, then he died.
Come on, God.
But in the day of judgment, he's going to answer for disobeying God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I tell people all the time, don't live a regular life and think somebody can treat you into heaven. It's not going to happen.
It ain't going to happen. You're lying.
Hallelujah.
It's going to hurt
you. This young man died of an overdose of drugs. The mother couldn't get the preacher to preach in the field because they didn't know it. And she asked me, I said, I don't have to know him. I know Jesus.
Amen.
I'll be glad to preach at the funeral. And let me tell you something. In that church, they had a choir, all young people. There was one young lady came in there, she was pregnant. She had on a sunbag dress with a purse, but the strap coming across the shoulder. And God gave it to me in the message, somebody had got a gun and want to shoot somebody. Now she was going to shoot another young lady over him, and he dead. And what happened when she found out that, she started shaking. How did you know? I said, because God told it to me.
He will speak to you.
Hallelujah. And I'm telling you today, if this is one thing you need to know, start jumping in every prayer line that comes.
All right. Yes. You that for you say?
You are the living sin and you
are the living
sin. You take the person to take and get it up.
Come on, get it up.
You got to do something yourself.
Amen.
You got to confess your sins to God. You got to repent and get right with God.
That's
right.
What you do.
And if you would do that, you wouldn't have all these sickness.
Right. Yes. Right.
You wouldn't have all of this high blood
pressure.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
That's why he said, even people called by his name, humble themselves and pray. Seek his faith. Turn from your wicked ways.
Yeah.
sin, we really forgot how to repent. Hallelujah.
Please.
When you have sin on top of sin, he kills your conscience.
Yes, he do.
And when you do wrong, you have nothing to change that you're wrong.
All right.
You will do wrong and think you're right.
Yes, they will.
Because he said in the last day, every man is right in his own eyes.
Yeah.
That's right.
The day would come and it would come wrong, right, and right, wrong.
Amen.
We in that day right now. That's why you better learn the word of God for yourself. I thank God for Mr. Tig and for those that Bishop Brennan did have these Bible classes.
Amen.
That's what Bible class is for.
That's right.
And I tell the guys that we teach over at the halfway house, you don't just sit here and listen. I want you to make some comments or ask questions.
Yeah.
That's what Bible class is about.
Yeah.
If you're going to sit up there and do all the teaching, they don't say nothing. What kind of class is that?
That's right.
And I'm going to say this today. Every member of the church ought to learn how to be in Sunday school.
Amen.
Amen. You may not like it, but you need to be in Sunday school.
Amen.
That's why they call it school, because that's where you learn.
Yeah.
You can't ask no question when the man is up preaching, women are preaching. That's the question. You come to Sunday school.
Yes.
And I know this, in our church in San Antonio, what we did, we gave them the books of the Bible. We gave them 30 days to learn the books of the Bible.
Amen.
And everyone that quoted correctly would give them $25. And after they learned the books of the Bible, then we had Bible drill.
Yeah.
We would call the scripture, and the one that finds the path, that's the one would get the money.
Amen.
Then we gave them a test with questions in the Bible. They had to do that test and bring the paperwork back.
Amen.
You've got to know the word of God.
I got to.
People will tell you anything.
Yes.
That's right.
And if you don't know it, you'll believe that man.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But I know one thing, sin is not worth going to hell for.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hell is a place of torment. Hell is a place where there's nothing but suffering and torture 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
My God.
Let me tell you, heaven is a holy place.
It is.
Matthew chapter 7, he said, not everyone that said unto him, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
But he had done the will of his Father.
Yes.
And when we stand before God to be judged, the gates of heaven is going to be open.
Yes.
And you're going to stand there and you're going to look in heaven. You're going to see all the angels, see them streaks of gold, and you're going to say to yourself, if I could just get 1 foot in. But then when he judged you and the angels throw you into hell, it's too late to cry. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Heaven was a holy place.
Hallelujah.
Everybody want to go to heaven, but everybody don't want to live holy.
Don't want to die.
That's why he said, follow Jesus. No man shall see the Lord. Hallelujah.
Only with him.
They talk about it with this same Saint Mary. Ain't no God in that mess.
No, yeah.
Two women can't have no child.
Can't do it.
Two men can't have no child.
Can't do it.
You got two women in the house, which one they can call daddy?
Hallelujah. Two men can't have no child.
Who knows?
That's not God. They don't know if you mention this, but they call it this a hell. Hallelujah. Bishop knew it all day. They tell me I'm going to preach the hell out of people, but we need to go back and start preaching the hell out of them.
We sure do.
Yeah, but they're full of hell. Sitting up in church full of hell. Sitting up in the poor bitch full of hell. We're in big towers full of hell. They do you wrong and never say I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But let me tell you one thing. If you don't repent, God is not going to hear your prayer.
Yeah.
If you don't forgive one another, He's not going to forgive you.
Come on.
We got to live by the whole word of God.
Yeah,
men should not live by the word of God, but by every word.
Yeah.
don't know how a brother and sister get alive. Shit. Get up and break it with the Lord. Bring it to church. Hallelujah. that the bishop of Indiana then passed away.
Hallelujah.
And they spent $40,000 on his funeral.
Come on.
I don't care how much money you put in the ground, it's not going nowhere.
Amen.
It's just going to lay in the ground and deteriorate. Why don't you help somebody that needs help that God can give you?
Hallelujah.
We talk about how much love we got, and we wouldn't give a person a glass of water.
Yes. Come on.
We come to Jesus, and if you say you love him who you have not seen,
yes,
and don't let the one you're losing, you are lying in the truth.
Yes, 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 Lord.
Hallelujah. God's love is real. Yes. Not on puppy love, but it's real.
Yeah.